from Emin Primary School.
My name is Kotensi, 8 years old, primary 2, also from Emin Primary School.
We'll start a new chapter in Calculus. Chapter 4, Further Differentiation.
Last chapter.
Chapter 3, Differentiation. We've learned about the definition.
Yes.
We also learned how to use the definition to prove formulas, the three rules.
Which three?
The product rule, quotient rule, and the chain rule.
Yes.
And some basic differential formulae.
Okay.
In the primary school mathematics, we learned the four operations.
Plus, minus, times, divide. Yes.
Okay.
Divide.
What if I say B is?
B is A plus 9.
A plus 5. Okay?
Okay.
Can I write like this?
Okay, equals A. Yes, do the inverse operation, do addition and subtraction. That's the opposite of each other. Totally addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, there is multiplication, and this is division.
Is it like this?
Yeah.
So these are the inverse operations.
Actually, all the inverse trigonal, the inverse logarithm, actually you're all inverse operations.
Yes, correct.
Okay. We also can
inverse trigonal.
Yes.
It can be like?
Yes. Sine f equals a, that means x will equals inverse x.
Inverse sine A. Correct?
Yes, inverse sine A. Cos plus.
Okay. So this is the inverse trigonal, right?
Yes.
We call it inverse operation.
Yes, what about the other, which is the logarithm? Inverse operation, another type. But we don't call it inverse logarithm.
Or whatever, inverse, right? We just call it inverse operation. This is?
This is long y. What is this? I know inverse operation, but what type? Right, sir?
Okay, so there are many, many types of inverse operation, right?
And what is this type?
Okay, so over here.
Okay.
All of these are the inverse operation, correct?
No.
What if? Do you know the differentiation of?
What?
Sine x.
Yeah. It's cosine x.
Yes, correct. It is cosine x.
Okay.
But what if I just add something behind? Like plus 4.
Okay.
What is it?
Plus 4. Still the same.
Same what?
Cosine x.
Okay, cosine x. But what if I'm minus?
Still cosine x?
Are you sure?
Yes.
Yes. And you're correct. So it's like this, right?
Yes.
So, like this is that we find the differentiation, correct?
Correct.
But what if we do the exact inverse?
That means
from this differentiation.
like that.
From this differentiation we get, we inverse the process.
So, let me do an adjective.
What we need to use is the integral.
Okay.
Do you know what is it like?
I know what is the formula.
Wait, do you know what is the sign?
Yes.
I'm asking for a sign.
A long, long, snakey, winky.
Something like a snake, right?
Yes. A long, long, snakey, winky. But not that long.
We'll need to use that integral sign.
I tell you, the formula.
What if I want, you know, the differentiation of sine x, correct? Which is
yes.
Cosine, right? Cosine x, correct? What if I wanted to go backward? We already know that this is a sine, correct?
Yes.
But
what you see?
We don't need a plus minus, we just add a plus.
What is C? What constant? What?
The arbitrary constant.
Okay. No, that's not how.
Like this, okay?
And C can...
Okay, C can be any number. Remember, it's a number. Any number except... What?
X.
Yes, those numbers that contain X. Okay. So do you get what is C?
Yes.
Okay, we call it the arbitrary constant.
Okay, the
it can be any number.
Yes, we call it arbitrary because it can be any number.
Except numbers contain X.
Yes.
Okay. What if I give you a few examples of these?
Okay, but if this A does need to be A, whatever this is, this cannot be.
What if I give you a sine X?
Okay.
X. Okay. Can you just straight away write cosine X plus whatever?
Okay.
Cosine X plus this. Do you remember the differentiation of cosine X? Don't need a negative, but here don't have a negative.
Negative.
So?
Negative. Negative. Negative.
Correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is a negative cosine X. Okay?
Forever.
E to the power of x is still
e to the power of x.
arbitrary constant. Okay, look over here.
Okay.
What about dx over x? What's it?
Dx over x is...
What do you think? 1 over x.
X plus arbitrary constant.
Like this. Right?
Yeah.
Yes, very good. So this, all these belongs to indefinite integral. Why?
Why?
They have these. They can be anything.
Okay.
Any number except x.
Yes. Which?
But what happens if it is a definite integral? Do you know what happens?
What?
Okay, let me show you.
Erase.
Okay. If it is definite, watch what happens.
What? Is it definite? Is it?
Yes, the second.
No, okay. It'll be cotangent.
3, right? this is half, negative half. Here is also a negative.
Okay.
Because the in front here doesn't it?
Okay.
So behind we will minus something. We'll minus something.
Okay.
Behind.
We'll minus.
Look, sub the zero.
Okay, sub the zero.
Sub the zero, so it's straight away. So here is a negative. Negative, positive.
Okay.
So it's a plus half. Plus half. Okay?
Equals.
So this watch. Negative, negative. Right?
Positive, is it?
Yes, positive. 1/1.
1/1.
Yes. Then?
1 plus 1/2.
Yes, so it is?
It is 3/4,
of course.
4.
Okay, so I'll clear out these. Okay, so right now we'll stop over here, okay?
Okay.
Okay.